So you just upgraded to Town Hall 10 and you have no idea what to do. In this video, we're going to talk about all the things you should be upgrading offensively and defensively, and what attack strategies and defensive layouts you should be using to best be competitive in Clan Wars. Let's start off with offense and the first few things you should be upgrading. You want to start by upgrading your army camps, your clan castle, your spell factory, and your laboratory. These four different types of upgrades are all necessary to get you to the point where you're a Town Hall 10 in terms of offense. It enables you to start upgrading troops, to have the extra spell space, and to have the extra troop space that you need to attack like an actual Town Hall 10. Get those initial upgrades done as soon as possible, and once you've done that, you can start to focus on specific troops and spells. The first three things I recommend doing is the bowler, the hog rider, and the heal spell. Doing these three upgrades will allow you to start doing 10v11 attacks with bowlers and to start doing 10v10 attacks against low-level Town Hall 10s, going for the 3-star with hog rider attack strategies. Some people like to upgrade farming troops first so you can upgrade faster in the future, but I think the Town Hall 9 troop levels are fine for farming, and you should focus on these war troops and spells. We will take a look at some examples of how you want to actually use these troops and spells in attacks, but first, let's take a look at the next few recommended upgrades I have, which is the tanks, the golems, lava hounds, and then the giant, as well as some of your dark spells. Now, I recommend doing these next because the golem is very useful. Level 4 golem is still decent, but level 5 makes a difference. Once you upgrade the lava hound, you can start to do La Lune attacks as well. And because the single infernos are so popular, upgrading the giants is helpful because they're often used to tank for your heroes in kill squad based attacks. Now, at the same time as these offensive upgrades, you also want to be upgrading your defenses because all of the offensive upgrades besides the clan castle cost elixir and dark elixir, and your gold can be spent on the defenses while you're doing this. So the first thing you want to do is get all the traps and all the new buildings, upgrade your traps to max. That's giant bombs, bombs, air traps, skelly traps, all that kind of stuff, as well as get the new defenses to the level of Town Hall 9 max, basically the level of all your other current defenses. Get those new defenses up to that level. Once that's all done, including the walls, which should be no more than one level below the rest of your walls, you can start with the next round of upgrades, and I recommend air defenses and Teslas. You need those max Town Hall 10 air defenses if you're going to defend successfully, because air attacks can dominate and destroy your base pretty quickly if you have Town Hall 9 level air defenses. Teslas, of course, are very nice because they do quite a bit of damage once you upgrade them, and they're a surprise defense so that it can make your base look weaker than it really is by having max Teslas and getting those done before your other defenses. Now, after that, I would recommend getting the level 1 Inferno Towers. There's a lot of debate about when to actually get these. Some people say do it a lot later because they add to your war weight, which goes into the matchmaking system for Clan Wars. But if you want to be competitive in wars, especially arranged wars like friendly challenges and stuff, you need to get those infernos down so you're not exploiting the Town Hall 10 system and you actually are getting the defenses to match your offense as you progress through this Town Hall level. After the infernos are down, you can keep them at level 1 for a while and just slowly upgrade them. Now you want to start working on expos, archer towers, and wizard towers. I would say especially the expos first, then the wizard towers, then the archer towers. The expos and wizard towers are very strong defenses once you get them upgraded. The wizard towers have 2 levels, so you can start working on the first level, then maybe wait, do the archer towers, then get back and do the second level. But they are very strong because they're high in hit points and they do that splash damage to both hogs and balloons. The expos, of course, are good anti-queen walk defenses, and they have the range that some of the other point defense doesn't have. Of course, there's way more to upgrade at Town Hall 10, but this is the basic stuff to get you started offensive and defensively. Okay, a quick note on heroes, because you're probably wondering where the hero upgrades fit into all of this. and they're not as important as they are when you become a Town Hall 9 and you just get that new Archer Queen. You can hang out with level 30 heroes for a while, do those troop upgrades first that you saw in the last screen, and then start to do your heroes, do the queen to 40 first, and then do the king all the way up to 40. Don't upgrade them simultaneously. I found doing the queen first is the best method for improving your attack. So you're just gonna wanna limit the role of your heroes, and we'll talk about that as we look at some of the attacks, until they become 40-40. Okay, so let's get into these attacks. They are going to be with maxed out heroes and troops, but that's just because of the attacks that I have access to, and we can talk about them as well in the context of lower level heroes and some troops that aren't maxed out. So basically, you may find yourself starting out with a lot of 10v11 two-star attacks, depending on your clan. If there are better upgraded Town Hall 10s, they might try the trickier 10v10 3 stars, assuming you're in wars that involve Town Hall 11s. If not, you probably will go into 3 star attacks right away. But it's worth spending an attack talking about 10v11 attacks, and it's pretty simple. You don't need max heroes, you just need those bowlers to be upgraded, really. Once you have those level 2 bowlers, you're pretty much going to be good to go. You need to create a funnel on two sides of a base and then send the king, possibly the queen. She died early on this attack, but it just shows the room for error you have at Town Hall 10 when attacking for these two-star attempts. Just send a bunch of bowlers and possibly other troops and your heroes in towards the Town Hall once the funnel's been created on both sides. And that's pretty much it. There are other ways to do it, but for new Town Hall 10s, this is the simplest way. Create a funnel on either side and then send in your troops with rages and heals and get that Town Hall down. And with some archers and baby dragons and stuff to snipe off buildings, possibly minions, you should be able to grab that 50%. It's gotten a lot easier after the Inferno Tower nerf to execute these 10v11 attacks. But if you need more help, more advice, you can check out my other videos I have specifically on 10v11 or ask in the comments below. But let's get to 10v10 because this is something that a lot of people want to master. And there's 3 attack strategies that you're going to want to focus on and learn. And they're all compatible with the upgrades I talked about on the last screen. So basically, you have the witches already at level 2 from Town Hall 9. Get the bowlers done. You have the healers. The giants might not be upgraded at first, but you can get those upgraded somewhat soon. And with the heal spell upgraded, your spells should be fine. The jump spell can be level 2. That doesn't matter very much. Same with the dark spells. Those are relatively unimportant. Basically, on this one, you're sending in flanks on each side and then a bunch of bowlers into the middle of the base. You can use witches or a queen walk on the sides. So sometimes you send your queen in with the bowlers and use witches on each side. You have the option of putting healers on the witches to help them stay up longer, which was done on this attack. Also, the queen was used on the outside as well on this attack. And then basically you want to use all your spells on the bowlers, typically 2 jumps, 2 rages, and 1 heal for the middle. And get through, get both those Inferno Towers taken out. The bowlers will probably die, but the witches and the queen should wrap up the back end of the base if they're still alive, which hopefully they are. If you send the queen in with your bowlers, she can typically take out more with her ability towards the end of the push through the base, which means there's less for the witches to have to take out. The healers are very helpful if the witches are going to encounter wizard towers or other splash damage, so just keep that in mind. But this is the very basic outline of the strategy. Like I said, it's compatible pretty much right away. Once you get those bowlers upgraded, you can start trying this out. Now, also, I talked about doing the hogs and the heal spell. The heal spell, of course, applies to the last attack as well, but it's even more important for this attack that you get it done. Basically, this next one is just a simple what would be the acronym for it? It would be a gobo or a goho, if you include the hogs. Basically, a golem, bowlers, and your heroes to take out a small portion of the base, and then hogs for the rest of the base. Your spells are going to be typically a jump of rage for your kill squad and three heals for your hogs, two poisons, one for the CC slash heroes, one for the skeleton traps that get onto your hogs. Basically look to do this when you can send in a kill squad to take out both heroes as well as some valuable defenses. Don't even need to get an Inferno Tower taken out because the hogs can take out both of them if they're deployed properly. And then you just kind of spread them in. You sprinkle them along the attack, reinforcing as you go, kind of like balloons. You're going to kind of push those hogs through the middle of the base or whatever middle is left. You got to be wary of giant bombs, of course, and spring traps, but a well-planned attack can crush some bases even if not all your troops are upgraded all the way. Now, wall breakers, wizards, these are important troops to do eventually, but they won't make or break your attack. You can have Town Hall 9 level wizards and wall breakers and still execute these attacks. You're just going to be, especially with lower level heroes, you're just going to be attacking bases that are a little bit lower level. That's how this is going to work until you get maxed out troops and heroes. It's going to be tough to take out maxed Town Hall 10 bases that are good designs, although it is possible. That's basically the attack, though. This attack suicided the queen, but typically your queen will go in with the kill squad, and that'll get it some more value, let it get deeper into the base. But sometimes you have to suicide her to help create the funnel for the rest of the kill squad going into the base. Golems are also important to upgrade, as I talked about, but they're not quite as important as the hogs and the bowlers are. So you can kind of wait to do those as your third dark troop that you do. Now, on that note, let's go ahead and go down here. Didn't cut this part out. This is the attack I'm looking for. We're talking about La Lune now as kind of a third attack you can learn. The first two are going to be your main go-tos. But if you're comfortable coming from Town Hall 9 with these air attacks, this can be a very powerful thing to do against bases that you don't want to hit with the Witch Bowler and you also don't think can work well with hogs. You can deploy this strategy, which has a lot of variations in terms of the size of the kill squad. Some people do queen charges. Keep in mind, as a Town Hall 10 with level 30 heroes to start, especially a level 30 queen, doing a queen walk or a queen charge is not going to be a good option to start, besides possibly using a queen walk along the outside of a witch bowler attack just to clean up one of the flanks. But besides that, you're not going to want to do these elaborate queen charges. She's best off with the kill squad. Sorry about that notification there. So anyway, basically in this attack strategy, you want to bite off a small piece of the base with your kill squad. You can use just your heroes, you can use golems, you can use valks, bowlers, whatever kind of works for the situation. You just kind of, you have to look at the base and just see what's the best option. But at that point, you send in your La Lune. You're going to use the haste spells, which you want to upgrade eventually. Not that important. If you have level 2 haste, it's not a huge deal. So don't worry too much about your haste spells. And then rages and heals. The heals are good for the back end of the base. Once those balloons start to finish up, if they get too clumped up, you got to protect them from the splash damage of wizard towers and red air bombs. So the queen gets some great value in this attack, and he has that heal spell, which is very helpful for the last expos and wizard towers and archer towers. So a very nice attack here. But yeah, this is that last attack that you might want to think about practicing and learning, and you can do it as soon as your lava hounds are upgraded, and you can go ahead and start practicing it. But of course, there's a ton of upgrades, a ton of more attacks that you will eventually learn and do at Town Hall 10, but this is the basic stuff to get you started. You might be attacking bases that aren't as well designed as the ones in this video, and that'll just make it easier to use your lower level troops and heroes. If you want more specific ideas, you can take a look at some of my other videos. But let's transition into defensive base building at Town Hall 10. Okay, so I found that the best way to do this is just to kind of go through an example base, how I would build it, what the steps are, and based on this example and the process, you guys can build your own anti-3-star Town Hall 10 bases. If you do have to defend against 2-stars, given the situation, maybe you're the top Town Hall in your clan, then you can put the town hall close to the center, but also it's a good idea to still use these techniques to make it an anti-3-star base. So the first step, as shown here, is to make the core. Like I said, the town hall might have to be in this, but assuming you just want to have an anti-3-star base, the core is a good place to put your queen, your clan castle, possibly air sweepers, a bomb tower next to the queen to prevent her from getting killed by a skeleton spell in like a suicide hero La Luna attack or something like that. It's a good idea to keep the bomb tower next to her. And also you can put expos, but in this core, we're going to keep it simple with these four buildings. So after that, you want to decide where the Inferno Towers are going to be relative to the core. You want to keep them so that bowlers inside the core can't target either Inferno Tower, because the biggest priority is defending against bowlers going through your base as they are in kill squad based hog attacks or witch bowler attacks. That's a big threat, so keep them separated from the core, and you can also fill in compartments and a few other defenses based on where the Inferno Towers are. And of course, you want to keep those Inferno Towers on single target mode. No point using multis at this stage in the game, especially for a new Town Hall 10. The next step here is to fill in the rest of the compartments. I find that makes it easier to plan out the rest of your base. You can start putting defenses down with the entire base layout in mind. So right here, we have the rest of the compartments filled out. Pretty simple stuff, just making these compartments to make the CC and the core be right in the middle, and then making it difficult to jump through the base with just two jump spells, avoiding getting hit by a witch bowler attack. So you want to have it just very difficult to jump through the base with those jump spells, and then also fill in the expos and air defenses. I like keeping the air defenses in range of the Inferno Towers so they can quickly pop lava hounds, as well as the expos set back enough that the queen cannot reach them on a queen walk. Another good practice to do. Okay, so after that, we're going to go ahead and fill in some more defenses, rest of the bomb towers, wizard towers, and I think we put the king down as well. You want to keep the king away from the queen is what I would recommend for a new Town Hall 10. That way he can kill hogs if the attacker uses a small kill squad just to take out the queen. The king can stay alive to kill hogs. Wizard towers, of course, keep them out of range of the air defenses so they won't be tanked by a lava hound. I went ahead and also put the other air sweeper down and pointed them in directions to cover most of the base. So next, we're going to start to fill in this base even more with the rest of the defenses. That's the archer towers, the cannons, and anything else remaining besides the mortars and the Teslas that we haven't already put down. Also putting these storages around the base and just starting to fill out the rest of the empty space. A few key ideas is put these cannons more heavily around the air defenses. That way the attacker won't get that great of value in a La Luna attack if they go for a kill squad to take out those air defenses. Keep the archer towers spread out so that there's not a huge part of the base that doesn't have any air coverage. And I think the storages, just kind of use those intermittently where needed to kind of hold up a kill squad or any non-defensive targeting troop trying to enter your base. It makes it take longer, and that gives your defenses time to take stuff out. So now at this point, we can put down Teslas, mortars in your main traps, including giant bombs, spring traps, and skeleton traps. A nice new kind of practice has been to put the Teslas in pairs with giant bombs between them on the outside of the base where the attacker isn't expecting to have to use a heal spell when they're doing a hog attack. So that's a good thing to do. Forces a heal spell can kill hogs if they don't have a heal. So I went ahead and did that on this attack, just kind of in areas you wouldn't expect to find defenses. The spring traps, of course, between defenses, getting as many hogs as possible, intend to be away from the queen to avoid getting taken out by a kill squad. Skeleton trap, went ahead and put one on air. The rest of them are on ground. One's to defend the queen in like a suicide hero entry at the bottom. The other is up top by the king to kind of help kill hogs and add to the damage at the top of the base along with that double cannon. So the final step here can be to fill in all the additional trash buildings. That's the non-defensive buildings like army camps, gold mines, all that kind of stuff. And also those last traps that we didn't have in the previous step. Those are the air traps and the small bombs. So you can see one thing I identified for this base is that it was likely to get hit by suicide heroes at the bottom of the base to take out air defenses, Inferno Tower, the Queen. That's possibly a very good value in the kill squad there, just with heroes potentially. So put the Town Hall down there to add to the hit points, making it more difficult. As I said previously, we have a skeleton trap to help distract the heroes upon entry, and a bunch of small bombs to kill wall breakers that go up to the wall. We've used the rest of the small bombs as well around the outside of the base to kill wall breakers, keeping them one tile away from the wall. That's the best position. And then the seeking air mines I put on the opposite side of the base on those two air defenses that are less likely to get taken out by a kill squad and more likely to get hit by a lava hound. That's where I put the seeking air mines, as well as the red air bombs away from the air defenses, near the wizard towers and just other sections of the base likely to get hit by balloons. So that's where the wizard towers go, and I think that pretty much covers the entire base. That's it for this video then. Thank you guys for watching. Hope it helped those of you new Town Hall 10s watching. I might even make one for Town Hall 11 depending on how the feedback is. I have one for Town Hall 9 if you have a Town Hall 9 account, or if you're a Town Hall 9 watching this video, you can check that out. For those of you who just upgraded to that Town Hall level. But anyway, that will do it. Let me know if you have any questions, additional things that I left out. Put those in the comments below, and I'll see you guys later. Bisectatron out.